And now we have one of the musical icons of our era. You know, Stevie Wonder, in many ways, got some of his craft from our next iconic legend. He started out in Plainview, New Jersey, the barbershop group that he half owned. Yeah. Berry Gordy heard about him, snatched him up, and brought him to Detroit. Thank him for Stevie and many of the other creative producers that are over at Motown or were at Motown during the 60s and 70s. He then became the most creative force, I believe, in musical history. Yeah. Who else can have a spaceship fly across the ceiling? I don't know if y'all were there. I was there. You don't even see the string hanging. All you see is a spaceship. And when it lands, you see George Clinton jump out and say, "Star Child!" Who else can you see the type of creations, Aqua Boogie, yeah, and many of the other most creative and visionary ideas in music? Talked about the atomic dog. Yeah. Who would even think of that? So it is indeed a pleasure for me to first let you see the video of the great iconic man, George Clinton.
Pioneer at helping and honing other people's abilities and talents and helping them become individuals on their own, like he did for Bootsy Collins and Catfish and all of the great musicians that played for him. He allowed them, you know, to do their own thing. And that's what I've been able to do, to take on that, to be a leader in the studio.
We're trying to give the information to people who copyright is coming back to them. We're gonna make an announcement that, okay, you made this record 35 years ago, your stuff is coming up for recapture. We're gonna start doing that on my birthday. We're gonna announce that as our foundation to help people to get their copyrights back. So it can be a more equitable thing for people that write, you know, R&B music or any music. Didn't know at that time that that video part right there would be in Dr. Dre's video. They not only sample the music, they sample the videos, because we all are one nation under the groove. You know, the G-Funk, P-Funk, and the whole generation of hip-hop.
I try not to be preaching.
Yes, sir.
I try to make it funny. You know what I'm saying? I know what's going on. I ain't trying to be no role model. You don't follow me.
Gotcha.
I don't want to lead nobody down no road that I ain't ready to go down myself.
And when you say free your mind, your ass will follow. That really
you'll figure out what to do with
absolutely,
that.
Absolutely, absolutely.
You'll figure that one out for yourself.
Absolutely.
You know, I ain't trying to preach it. I don't know no answers. Yeah. I just know that learning how to learn is really important.
So really, getting people to question is the ultimate answer.
Ultimate answer. Oh, my whole thing is to say something to make you. What is he talking about?
Yes, sir.
Why is he talking about that? What? I just throw it out there. Now, I ain't gonna. It may be true now for the next 10 years, but after 10 years, society may change, and that may be the worst thing they could have been into.
Absolutely.
So I ain't trying to convince nobody. You know, I know it's a movement, but it's a movement to dance your way out of your constriction.
Absolutely. Because freedom ain't about following the new rules.
No.
It's about being free.
Learn how to learn.
Absolutely.
George Clinton, you all, bring him up. Bring him up. He's a legend. You saw that spaceship that's in the Library of Congress, in the Smithsonian. His spaceship, the mothership, is in the Smithsonian. We say Dr. Dre is the best producer of our time. Well, he learned from George Clinton. He copied from George Clinton. When you see Dr. Dre, you see George Clinton. When you see all the hip hoppers, you see the iconic brother, and we love you to death. Brother George Clinton.
Original Atomic Dog, George Clinton, the Legend Award.
Let me get this together. Oh, good. First of all, I want to thank Ben, my man, my friend, frat brother, and all that. And thank y'all for being here. But one thing I want to say, you said Motown Barry, it was Miss Janie Bradford over there. Yeah. I was 17 years old. Wow. I wrote a letter to Motown saying I want to be a songwriter. She set me up, and I've been chasing Smokey Robinson ever since.
Yeah. Give it up for Miss Janie, huh?
Miss Janie Bradford right there. First of all, I want to say thank you, Ben, for this meaningful acknowledgement. As I look around and see this crew I'm being honored tonight with, it is very humbling because to me, I'm just a music maker. I am a fighter. The same war for equal justice on a different battlefront, and that is for equal justice for artists against a system designed to underpay, deny ownership, and control over our creative output.
Yes, sir.
A battle that has its roots in sharecropping. So I'm proudly received this award representing all the members of the band that you know, Parliament Funkadelic, Brides of Funkenstein, Parlette, Bootsy Collins, and all the other members of the band. I stand on their shoulders as I receive this award, and I thank y'all very much. And we will keep on fighting for those rights. Along with my attorney, we're gonna get those rights back. We're gonna get them all back.
The one and only George Clinton.
We want the funk.
Make my folk the P-Funk. Flashlight. Atomic Dog. The Mothership Connection. I'd rather be with you.
One nation
under a groove.
The Humpty Dance.
The Humpty Dance. He's the most sample musician in the history of music. So Judge, we're gonna make sure that George get every one of his intellectual properties and masters back. George Clinton.
Now this is what I want y'all to do. If you got faults, defects.